A 40-year wait is finally over for Warriors fans. Cavs fans, I mean, Mozgov looked good for next year. Hey, I'm Mike Janella for 8012. It was certainly a long wait, but now that Dub Nation's off the board, which fan base from our major sports leagues is most desperate for a championship? The answer might surprise you. In the NBA, we're actually swerving. It's not the Cavs. Have you seen Hoosiers? Indiana is basketball crazy. They had the biggest jump in local cable ratings in the NBA last year, and it's not like Pacer fans have a lot to distract themselves with. The Colts are the only other big league team in town, and the Pacers have never won an NBA title, 39 seasons and counting. Football has so many good options for this. Bills fans, Browns fans, Vikings fans, Lions fans. For a league that's all about parity, there are a lot of teams that have never won. But Eagles fans are hurting the most. 49 seasons in the NFL, zero Lombardi trophies. They throw snowballs at Santa and they cheer opponents leaving on stretchers, but it's not because they're asses. It's because they just want to win so bad. The Cubs are baseball's obvious representative. Their 107-year World Series drought is longer than any other two droughts here combined. But six Bulls titles in the Jordan era and three Blackhawks Cups the last 6 years kind of eases the pain. Plus, Cubs fans are probably some of the happiest in baseball. They get to watch games and drink during the day. And have you heard their theme song before? Are they Cubs games or Jimmy Buffett concerts? No, for the thirstiest fan base, we gotta go north of the border. The Maple Leafs haven't won a Stanley Cup since 1967. They've only made the playoffs once the last 11 years, yet they charge the highest average ticket price in the NHL at $112. And fans still pay it. The Leafs had a 13-year sellout streak come to an end just this season. The waiting list for season tickets is 20 years long. When you're the only team in town, and your town's the biggest in the country, and your country's the most hockey-obsessed on Earth, makes something like the Curse of the Bambino feel shorter than a screening of Fever Pitch. Are we shortchanging any fan bases? Are those Knicks and Jets fans, I hear? Let us know in the comments, and we'll catch you later on 8012.
Thanks for watching 8012. To see more of us, subscribe to our channels, like our videos, and make sure to leave a comment. Now, I'm not telling you guys what to say, but if you wanted to go with a little hashtag Susanna Rocks, I'd be totally fine with that.